In this video, I'll share some example prompts you can use with ChatGPT. These will be helpful for your research, whether you're working on a research paper, thesis, or dissertation. First, if you are writing the background and literature review section of your research paper or thesis, you need to begin by collecting previously published articles. You can use a specific prompt to find relevant articles. For example, I asked ChatGPT to provide 5 recent, free access Google Scholar articles. Then, enter your topic and make sure the web search option is activated. After this, ChatGPT gave me 3 articles. One was a strong match, while the other 2 were only partially relevant because they did not discuss all of my topic elements, such as employee decision-making, satisfaction, and retention, together. Instead, they addressed these aspects separately. However, I still considered them a good match since they also related to my topic. The next step is cross-checking. Simply copy the article title, paste it into Google, and access the article. When you open it, you can verify that it was published after 2020 and is open access. Now, let's check the second article. Repeat the same process, open it, and confirm that it is also published after 2020 and open access. You can repeat this process to gather more articles. For example, suppose you now have 1 article but are unsure if it is fully related to your topic. In that case, you can copy the introduction section and the discussion section of that article. Next, ask ChatGPT whether the article is related to your topic. You can also include your topic title in the prompt. Paste only the introduction and discussion sections, not the entire article, since ChatGPT does not accept very long text. ChatGPT will then tell you if the article is related to your topic and provide a clear explanation. This method is especially helpful if you are new to the topic and find it difficult to understand how deeply it connects to your research. Now, for example, if you want to get specific information from an article or you need to write background or literature review, ChatGPT can help you with this in a short amount of time. Paste your question, specify the length of the response you want, and clearly state that the answer should be supported by findings from the article. Then, go to the article and copy the entire methodology and results section. Paste this content into ChatGPT along with your question, and ChatGPT will generate an answer directly from the article. You will see that it references the article's results and provides a detailed answer to your question. Now, suppose you want to compare the perspectives of 2 or more articles. In that case, give clear instructions such as compare article perspectives, paste your question, and, if needed, also ask ChatGPT to identify research gaps in the articles. The important point here is to number the articles so that ChatGPT clearly mentions the authors. For example, copy the author information from the first article you used previously, paste it, and assign it a number. Since this is a comparison, you will need at least 1 more article. Copy the author information from the second article, then copy its methodology and results section and paste it under the author's details. Make sure to include the publication date of each article. This way, you don't need to worry about citations, as ChatGPT will generate them correctly. After pasting both articles and their details, click Send. You will see that ChatGPT produces a strong comparison paragraph that also addresses limitations. It discusses both articles effectively. You can also create a literature review table without any effort. For example, you might instruct ChatGPT to include the authors, date, methodology, findings, and implications in a table format. ChatGPT will then generate the table according to your instructions. Finally, remember that since long texts cannot be pasted into ChatGPT all at once, you can repeat the comparison or literature review process by copying and pasting at least 3 articles together in smaller sections. Even with this limitation, the process saves a significant amount of time compared to doing everything manually. Now we will talk about how you can generate a new topic using ChatGPT and create research questions or a hypothesis from it. You can even select the most suitable methodology with the help of ChatGPT. You need to start by entering your area of interest and then instruct ChatGPT to connect the topic with a current issue. If you want, you can further customize your prompt by adding details such as your target population, state name, or other specifics. After doing this, I received several topic suggestions, and ChatGPT even recommended the best option, which was evaluating the effectiveness of urban green infrastructure policies in reducing carbon heat islands in megacities. ChatGPT also mentioned that it could provide a research question and a hypothesis. I agreed, and it generated both for me. If your aim is to explore a topic, you should choose the research question. However, if your focus is on measuring something, then you need a hypothesis. It is important to create a research question or hypothesis based on identified gaps, since this is a broad topic. For that reason, I asked ChatGPT to provide previous articles on this subject to help me identify gaps. ChatGPT gave me several articles, along with their key findings and the gaps. It also listed the gaps clearly. As I explained earlier in the video, you can open each article, copy the methods and results sections, paste them into ChatGPT, and instruct it to identify the gaps. I won't repeat those steps here because I already demonstrated the process earlier. Once you have those gaps, paste them into ChatGPT and ask it to create research questions based on them. At this stage, you will have a more concrete research topic. ChatGPT generated two research questions for me. For methodology, you can use ChatGPT to get initial ideas. Of course, you need to adapt the methodology to match your own resources and context. For example, I asked ChatGPT to create a research design that included a suitable philosophy, research approach, research design, sampling strategy, and data collection methods, while instructing it not to choose mixed methodology. It provided a good framework, recommending positivism as the philosophy and explaining why it was chosen. It also suggested a cross-sectional and comparative design, included an appropriate sampling strategy, and outlined clear methods for data collection and analysis. If you do not want to conduct fieldwork, such as visiting towns or neighborhoods, or if you do not have the resources for interviews or surveys, you can tell ChatGPT that you cannot do fieldwork. ChatGPT will then adapt the research design according to your requirements. In this case, it suggested collecting data from remote sensing, secondary socioeconomic sources, and policy data, using open data available online. This type of research design can serve as a strong draft to give you direction, and you can customize it further based on your available resources. Similarly, if you are confused about choosing theoretical frameworks or want to find some case studies related to your topic, you can create similar prompts. ChatGPT can also help with data analysis. Let me know in the comments if you would like to understand the data analysis process in ChatGPT. Don't forget to subscribe, share, and like for more helpful videos.